Now, the best way to improve the smoothness and timing of stop-motion animations is by improving your skill over time. Simply put, nothing will beat learning through trial and error the best ways in which to move your stop-motion characters, and through finding ways to make finer and more precise movements. Even for the techniques I will show you in post-processing, the better clips and movements you have going into it, the better results are. Now that we are past that, I'm going to show you how, using something called optical flow in Adobe Premiere, we can improve timing and smooth out stop motion clips for a better short film. Take this clip I recently took for an upcoming Lego brick film, and notice how, while relatively smooth, the clip seemed to jump slightly and the motion moves very quickly. The movements I have here are quite unrealistic and very fast for the type of stop motion film I'm trying to create. Comparatively, in this clip, I've added optical flow, getting the computer to add frames in between the photos I've taken and blend them together for smoother motion. On top of this, I can slow the movement down to make it flow much better with the rest of the film without lowering the frame rate. This establishing shot now can be used as intended instead of jumping quickly as it would if it were a higher action clip, as the raw footage would suggest. I can now ease into the action for my film instead of jumping right into it, all while producing a much smoother shot. Now, optical flow isn't perfect, as the computer is essentially guessing the action between photos, hence, the more information you can give the computer, the better the results will be. There tends to be issues with this when motion is overlapping and the computer can't see what's going on behind it, sometimes resulting in artifacting. In this example here, you can see how optical flow has missed some action as the LEGO minifigure moves his arm up and down, and the highest point of action has the most artifacts. This can be counteracted by ensuring the movement has the least amount of overlapping action as possible, as well as also shooting against a contrasting color such as white and black. Coming full circle, the more you can capture in the original stop motion footage, the more the computer will be able to guess correctly and will result in less artifacting. The benefit of this clip is that the motion is relatively smooth to begin with, without much going on in the background, and the result, while not perfect, is certainly more how I intended it to be, and these artifacts are typically overlooked in full-speed playback. A simple rule of thumb for this is, the better your animation is going in, the better the improvements optical flow will make on the output. Now let's jump onto the computer and I will show you how Adobe Premiere's optical flow can improve your LEGO stop motion movement. After loading up Adobe Premiere and starting a new project, the first step is loading in your original animation. I'm currently in the Assembly tab, and I'm just going to drag and drop my file in the Project Files window. Next, this file can be dragged and dropped into the timeline to start editing. As you can see, the video plays at its original shot and exported 30 FPS, and you can see the quick movement that I'm trying to counteract. The first step that I'm going to do is change the sequence settings to 60 FPS. This step isn't necessary if you don't want to change the original frame rate, but for me, I want extra smooth playback, and I want to push optical flow as far as it can for this example. You may notice, after hitting OK, that the clip gets a little jumpier in playback, as Premiere is trying to adjust my original frame rate to 60 frames per second. Next, right-click your clip in the timeline and change time interpolation to optical flow. Now, you will notice that this bar in the top of the timeline changes to red and the clip hasn't seemed to change. This is due to it not being rendered yet, but I have a few more things I want to change to the clip first. Right-click the clip once again and go into speed and duration and change the speed, if needed, to slow down or speed up the movement. I'm going to change this clip to 80% to slow down the movement slightly. Also here, remember to change the time interpolation here to optical flow as well. Now, to be able to see the changes that optical flow has made to your clip, we need to render this out. With the clip selected in the timeline, go to the sequence header and hit Render Selection. After a few seconds, the clip will render out, the red bar above the timeline will change to green, and we can play back our clip and view the changes optical flow has made. If all looks good here, you can simply export your clip and end here. For this example, I'm going to push optical flow a little further and slow it down even more. For this, I'm going to right-click the clip, and I'm going to change the speed and duration from the 80% I picked prior to something more extreme, such as 30% for extra slow motion. After any changes, we also have to render it out again. With this clip selected, I will go back into the sequence header and hit Render Selected once again. The bar above the timeline will go green, and we can see the massive changes optical flows made when compared to the original clip. As I'm sure you've noticed already, the more dramatic of changes you make with optical flow, the more artifacts your clip will have. Optical flow should be seen as something to make minor improvements rather than something to replace good animation altogether. Lastly, I will export the clip under File, Export, Media. Here, you can select your favorite export settings or follow mine. Just make sure you change the time interpolation at the bottom here to optical flow as well. After exporting, you can see the slowed down clip in its own exported file. This clip is all ready to add to your own stop motion animation. I hope this video will help improve some of your clips. I find it quite useful for improving the pacing and timing of animations, as it's quite easy to have stop motion footage look quite jumpy and quick. If you have any further questions or suggestions for future videos, please let me know in the comments down below and I will respond to as many as I can. Thanks for watching, and check out more videos on my channel for more of my work.